Assalamualaikum and hi guys. In this video, it's continuation from the previous one, which is you are still learning to balance the equation, but this one you are actually balancing a redox equation. And the method that you use to balance a redox equation, we call it as ion electron method. But first, let's learn what is redox equation. Minta introduce sikit lah. Redox equation simplenya adalah datang daripada perkataan red, datang daripada perkataan reduction, and ox datang daripada perkataan oxidation. So redox equation is an equation that contain both process, process reduction dan juga process oxidation. Since this equation dia ada dua proses yang berbeza, maka the way for you to balance them adalah berbeza berbanding inspection method, which is we call as ion electron method. Nama pun awak dah boleh agak bahawa dekat sini akan melibatkan ion dan juga elektron. To balance the redox equation, it depends on the condition of that solution. There are two types of condition that you have to consider. The first one is acidic condition, or kalau dia kata acidic solution, it's also referring to the acidic condition. And the second one is basic condition, or in basic solution. Redox reaction tu berlaku dalam keadaan apa? Dalam keadaan solution yang bersifat acidic or basic. So let's start by learning balancing redox equation by ion electron method for acidic solution. For this part, sama-sama tulis dengan madam. We are going to go through all steps together. You kalau rasa macam laju sangat, you pause and then you salin. Every step, you salin the equation. Alright, this is the redox equation that I'm talking about. Dia melibatkan ada ion kat sini. Dia nampak berbeza dengan previous video, which is reaction equation yang biasa itu. First step to balance this equation is you have to write the half equation. Half equation ialah, ni adalah full equation. Half maksudnya awak bahagi dua. So how you bahagi dua, you actually dividing them to two half equation. Satu equation yang bersifat oxidation, satu equation yang bersifat reduction. Sebab redox kan adalah gabungan daripada dua proses kan, reduction dan oxidation. So you pecahkan dia balik. First you kena tahulah dalam sini siapa yang undergoes oxidation, siapa yang undergoes reduction. Ada banyak cara sebenarnya. Contoh, awak kenal satu bahagian yang oxidation, so automatik lagi satu adalah reduction lah kan. Kalau madam, okay, sekali pandang tapi tak adil lah sebab kalau madam, sebab madam memang pensyarah kimia. Tapi the easiest, so I don't know lah, how about you guys. This one adalah oxidation. Kita boleh tengok daripada dia punya oxidation number. Kalau oxidation, oxidation number dia akan meningkat. Daripada sebelum ke selepas tu, dia akan meningkat. Contoh, this one. Cl minus, oxidation number dia berapa? -1. Kenapa -1 ni? Dia ada charge kat sini. So, dia punya oxidation number dia -1. This one, ada charge tak? Tak ada. Maka, Cl tu punya oxidation number dia kosong. So, you akan nampak, oh, -1 ke kosong meningkat. Automatik dia adalah oxidation reaction. Itu cara pertama dengan cara tengok oxidation number. Cara yang kedua adalah, okay, kalau awak dah tahu, the Cl minus to Cl2 is oxidation, automatic you will know this one reduction. If for you, it's very hard for you to identify siapa reduction oxidation, awak carilah cara paling mudah macam tadi. Madam tahu Cl minus ke Cl2 oxidation, automatic dengan pastinya yang lagi satu mesti reduction. Okay, but you have to make sure lah yang you paling yakin tu adalah oxidation based on apa yang you belajar. Dan lagi satu, tak payah fikir kenapa di reduction. Okay, sebab nampak pun ni macam agak complicated. Okay, alright. So kalau macam ini, kenapa reduction pula, macam mana madam tahu? Kalau if lah media identify warna hijau tu dulu. Biru ni tak wujud lagi. Yang biru, yang ink warna biru ni media tak decide lagi dia apa. Okay, media nak tengok Cr2O7 2- pergi Cr3+. Kenapa dia reduction? Sebab satu cara untuk tentukan reduction oxidation adalah number of oxygen. Bilangan oksigen. Kalau bilangan oksigen dia berkurang, maka dia undergoes reduction. Kalau you nampak kat sini, sebelum dia, dia ada 7 oksigen. Selepas tu, tak ada satu pun oksigen. Maksudnya bilangan oksigen yang ada pada compound tu telah berkurang. maka automatic dia undergoes reduction. You identify siapa reduction, siapa oxidation, then you akan pecahkan dia menjadi dua half equation. So this is the first half equation untuk reduction. This is the second one. Set mana set satu. Minta maaf lah kalau tak nampak eh. Settle step number one. Let's proceed to the second one. The second one is balance all atoms except hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, semua kecuali. Okay, alright. So kalau kat sini awak nampak, jangan tengok oksigen, kita tengok kromium. Sini ada dua, this one ada satu. Maka kena letak dua dekat depan Cr3+. Nampaklah ini. This one Cl dia jangan hiraukan, dia ni bercas, dia tidak bercas. No, kita jangan tengok tu dulu, that one later. Alright, kita tengok atom itself sahaja. Duk, jangan duk risau benda-benda lain. Madam ni Cr2 ni Cr3+. Okay, jangan duk risau benda tu dulu, okay. Alright, so this one ada 1 Cl, this one ada 2 Cl. Minta maaf kalau tak nampak, this one ada Cl2. So, dia ambil daripada atas eh. Mana nak padam. Okay, Cl2. So, ni ada 1 bilangan dia, ini ada 2. That's mean you have to put 2 in front of Cl minus. Settle second step. The third step is balance oxygen by adding H2O to the side that has less oxygen. Balance oxygen first. Sebab tadi oxygen hydrogen kita hold dulu kan. Okay, the third balance oxygen. But how? Okay, dekat side that has less oxygen, tambah H2O. Okay, tengok sini. For reduction equation, on the left side, okay, there are 7 oxygen. On the right side, no oxygen. That's mean kita kena letak oksigen sebelah kiri ke kanan? Kanan. How many? 7. Kenapa 7? Sebab sini ada 7. Sini tak ada langsung, maka kita kena letak 7 H2O. How about the oxidation reaction? Ada tak oksigen? Tiada. Maka skip step number 3. Right? Okay. Settle step number 3. Proceed to the step number 4, which is balance hydrogen by adding H plus to the side that has less hydrogen. Okay, again, check, okay, equation ini. Alright, okay, this one, on the left side, no hydrogen. On the right side, there are 14 hydrogen. Total, 7 times 2 is 14, 14 hydrogen. That means you have to put 14 H plus on the left side. Again, for the oxidation reaction, tak ada hydrogen here, maka kita skip. Next, step number 5. Okay, balance the charge by adding electron. Dia nak balance the charge. Okay, so now kita akan tengok charge kepada setiap satu substance yang ada di sini. Let's start with Cr2O7-. Apakah charge kepada Cr2O7-? Negative 2. How do I know? Tengok je charge kat sini, ha? Rujuk je tu, charge dia berapa. Okay, 14H plus ada berapa charge dia? Positif 14. Tulis positif itu. Katakan charge positif ke negatif. Kenapa 14 bukan plus 1? Sebab dia H plus tu plus 1, tapi ada 14 H plus itu. So total charge dia adalah positif 14. Bahagian reaktan ini nanti, total charge dia will be positif 12. Negative 2 plus 14. Total positive 12. Kita buat bahagian produk. Charge for 2Cr3 plus is plus 6. Charge for H2O berapa? 0. Kenapa? Sebab tak tulis charge pun kat sini. Tak ada charge lah. Kosong. So total charge on the product side will be positive 6. As you can see, look, the charge is unbalanced. Apa maksud admin dengan unbalanced? Tak sama nilai charge sebelah kiri dengan sebelah kanan. Dia kena sama, dia kena seimbang. Sebab kita pun tengah buat balancing, so seimbangkan charge dia. How? Okay, dia kata by adding electron. Okay, masa first video, okay, you ada belajar electron bercas apa. Electron bercas negatif. Satu elektron membawa negatif satu charge dia. Kita ada positif 12, kita ada positif 6. So kat mana elektron nak kena letak dan berapa banyakkah elektron yang awak kena letak to balance the charge? You kena letak 6 elektron on the reactant side. 6 elektron bercas negatif 6. satu elektron charge negatif satu. If you have 6 electron, the charge for 6 electron is negative 6. Total charge baru on the reactant side after you tambah 6 electron, the total charge is plus 6. Dah balance belum? Sudah. So that's how you balance the charge. Okay. So this is the half equation on reduction side for step number 5. Okay, so let's look at the oxidation part. Okay, so charge on the reactant side is negative 2. Charge on product side is 0. Balance tak? Tak. Negative 2, 0. Tak balance. Okay, so nak letak elektron dekat side mana? Dan berapakah? You have to put 2 electron on the product side sebab 2 electron charge dia negative 2. Then, on the product side, nanti total charge je akan dapat negative 2. So, it's the charge will be balanced on both reactant and product side. So, this is the equation for oxidation for step number 5. The last step, step number 6 is you have to combine two half equation. Tadi dah pecahkan kan? Gabungkan dia balik. Cara untuk gabungkan dia pula, first, you have to make sure, okay, to combine these two half equation, you have to make sure that the both half equation contain similar number of electron. Itu benda pertama kena buat. Kalau tak sama, tak boleh gabung. Tengok electron for reduction, there are 6 electron. For oxidation, there are only 2. Tak sama bilangan electron dia. Maka, samakan. Macam mana? Okay. Kita perlu ubah bahagian oxidation je lah, logically. Which is, you have to multiply the whole oxidation half equation with 3. So that nanti bila 2 electron times 3, nanti you akan dapat 6 electron. So, dah sama. And then, to combine them, you have to simplify the equation by cancelling any species that appear at both sides of the equation. Alright. My suggestion, and then you tulis lah atas bawah macam ni. Okay. Jika ada benda yang sama on opposite side, you boleh cancelkan dia. Apa benda yang sama antara dua equation ni? Benda yang sama adalah dia ada 6 electron. Then, dia duduk dekat opposite side. Bila dia duduk dekat opposite side, maka you boleh cancelkan dia. Tapi kalau benda tu duduk dekat same side, maka you tambahkan dia. Mungkin akan jumpa dekat dalam soalan tutorial. Mungkin akan ada lah macam tu. So, bila kita dah cancelkan, tinggal combinekan sahaja. Then you will get redox equation yang sudah balance dalam keadaan acidic. You punya final answer mesti ada H+. Plus sebab dia dalam acidic solution. That's mean equation awak mesti ada H+. Kalau tak ujung-ujung H+, kan? Maknanya adalah silap tu pada you punya balancing. Before we proceed to the second condition, I would like to remind you to balance this redox equation by using ion electron method. These are the steps. Okay? Memang banyak. Step dia memang banyak. Dan step itu perlu dilakukan mengikut turutannya. Dia tak boleh. Bila pertama korang dapat equation ni, terus nak balance oksigen. Tak boleh. Okay, buatlah satu-satu ikut step. Janganlah gelojoh sangat. Terus nak pergi ke step nombor 5. Okay, kalau awak gelojoh sangat pergi step nombor 5, salahlah caranya. Okay, salahlah jawapan awak.